Heads up.
Heads up.
Well, here we go. They're coming out.
Good afternoon. We just had a meeting of which you saw the introduction to. But coming out of the meeting, we can say that, as I mentioned to the president has the White House, he has the Senate, he has the House of Representatives, all in Republican control. He has the power to keep government open. Instead, he has admitted in this meeting that he will take responsibility. The Trump shutdown is something that can be avoided, that the American people do not need at this time of economic uncertainty, people losing jobs, the market in a move, and the rest. It's a luxury. The Trump shutdown is a luxury the American people cannot afford. I told the president, our leader, distinguished Senate leader, will talk about two proposals we made to the president. After he makes those proposals, I'll tell you another statement that I made to the president about those proposals.
Okay. The bottom line is simple. The president made clear that he wants a shutdown. His position, if he sticks to his position for a $5 billion wall, he will get no wall and he will get a shutdown. The bottom line is very, very simple. And that is, we want border security. We offered him border security, but Americans know that the wall, not paid for by Mexico anymore, is not the way to border security. And the experts say that. We offered the president two ways to avoid a shutdown. First, pass the six other appropriations bills that have been agreed to by Democrats and Republicans and do a one-year extension of the Homeland Security bill by what's called a CR, which just funds it the same way it funded it last year. Or do a one-year CR for all seven remaining appropriations bills. Both of those ways, we gave the president two ways, each of which would get a majority of votes in the House and 60 votes in the Senate and would avoid a shutdown. We hope he'll take it, because a shutdown hurts too many innocent people. And this Trump shutdown, this temper tantrum that he seems to throw, will not get him his wall. And it'll hurt a lot of people because he will cause a shutdown. He admitted he wanted a shutdown. It's hard to believe that he would want that.
Should unfortunately that the president choose to shut down the government, that we have a Trump shutdown as a Christmas present, a holiday present to the American people. I told the president that the new House of Representatives, when it convenes, will pass what Mr. Schumer suggested here, the distinguished Senate leader suggested, in terms of passing the six bills, the six appropriation bills that are agreed to in a bipartisan way, and have a continuing resolution until September 30th for the Homeland Security bill, during which time we can discuss these issues further. I told the president that would happen. We would send it to the Senate. He says, oh, we can pass it in the House, his bill right now in the House. He does not have the votes in the House to pass whatever his agenda is with that wall in it. We're telling him we'll keep government open with the proposal that Mr. Schumer suggested. Why doesn't he just think about it? In fact, I asked him to pray over it.
And one final point. No, stop. Okay? One final point. The $1.3 billion that we gave him last year for border security, no wall, but border security, less than 6% of it has been spent. They haven't even spent last year's money, and now they're demanding much, much more this year. Go ahead. Now, we're just going to take questions on this subject only.
Madam Speaker, given what we saw in there, the bickering, the back and forth, what does this say about your ability to work with this president over the next 2 years?
Well, I told the president, as I've said over and over again, this new Congress will be something different from the Congress we have now. It will be a Congress of transparency so that the American people can see, not passing a tax bill with $7 trillion impact on the economy in the dark of night, speed of light, so nobody can see what it is without hearings or any expert opinions on it. So it'll be about transparency. It'll be about reaching out, extending the hand of friendship to work in a bipartisan way to find common ground where we can, stand our ground, as Thomas Jefferson said, like a rock, where we can't, and about honoring the guidance of our founders, e pluribus unum, from any one. We didn't come here to divide, we came here to unify. And we extend that hand of friendship to him, which he seemed to like that course of action. He does not accept that hand of friendship, we still will be who we are, dignified, respectful of the institution that we represent in the Congress, and honoring the vision of our founders. Well, I thought it was unfortunate. I will just say this, you want to know if it was more productive behind the scenes. I hear some of the reporters saying, Fox reporters saying, why did we not want transparency in this discussion? We didn't want to contradict the president when he was putting forth figures that had no reality to them, no basis in fact. We have to, if we're going to proceed in all of this, have evidence-based, factual, truthful information about what works and what doesn't. I didn't want to, in front of those people, say, you don't know what you're talking about.
And one other thing here. The president said things are working quite well at the border. Well, we want to give him the same thing he had last year. If they're working well last year, they should work well this year. He shouldn't shut down the government. Thank you, everybody.
Yeah, we want to see all their little